And a lot of TSM doing awesome is probably because of their new shiny boot camp, but unfortunately, Saberlight, what are you doing with this old background? What am I looking at your bedroom for? What's going on?
What do you mean, unfortunately, Saberlight?
That's true.
Wow, my feelings are hurt right now, Tsunami. It's an
amazing bedroom. I'm so glad that you're getting to stay there instead of going to a shiny facility. I mean, it gets you the win anyway, but yeah, why aren't you at the boot camp?
It's just visa issues. I should be able to go for the next DPC, but right now we're trying to figure out the visa, and I don't know, it's like, you know, it's good enough to be TG, so I'm fine.
That's the spirit. Yeah, it's working out well for you. How'd you like that series? You were doing a lot of work. That Beastmaster game number two, you were looking in your element.
Thank you. It was because, like, right before the game, I was playing Brute to prepare, you know? And it was like a completely atrocious map. Like, no one wanted to play with me. I wanted to, like, abandon that game. And, you know, I took from my the treatment I got that game. And now I inflicted all the pain I had on Nightfall. I was like, you know, this guy's gonna suffer even more than I suffered. And yeah, that's the mindset I have.
Yeah, it showed, because that game, he was taking a great deal of abuse. And Mira, you've got any questions for Saberlight?
Yeah, I mean, the obvious question is, how are you feeling after getting signed to such a big organization? And how is that whole experience for you?
I mean, it's completely amazing. I think after playing unsponsored for a year, this is like a huge upgrade, and I think this is something that we strived for ever since we like got this team together. And what's even better is that now we beat EG, and EG is like one of the best NA Dota orgs for like the past 10 years. And now suddenly there's, you know, if we beat them as Undying, it's like considered an upset, but right now if you beat them as TSM, it's suddenly like a rivalry, and I think that can be very interesting for the fans, and it's certainly very interesting for us to play them like this.
That's definitely worth noting. Out of curiosity, we were kind of theory crafting on panel earlier, but have the NA teams been scrimming against each other during the off time, or has it just been chill?
I don't really know. What I can say for us, we took a break when, like, right after the end of the tiebreakers, we took like 2 weeks. Well, I mean, we just scrimmed less because we don't really take breaks. We just scrim like, let's say, one every 3 days. We had like one scrim, and we started scrimming EU teams mainly. Like when the guys arrived at bootcamp, I don't know how they do it, but we just play EU scrims with 150 ping, and I think they helped like a ton. I don't think we would play this good if we didn't play the EU scrims.
Wow.
Was that by design that you didn't want to play teams that you were going to face off against the regional finals, or you just thought EU's a good competition for you guys?
I don't know. I'm not. You have to ask our manager.
Well, how about in your experience? Did you find that the European teams were like more challenging than your NA scrims?
Certainly. Yeah, we were scrimming. I don't know if I can leak this, but whatever. We're scrimming VP a lot, and that team is insane. I think we learned a ton from them, so that was certainly helpful. I mean, we did scrim some of the NA teams. We scrimmed Quincy for a few games, so it's not exclusively EU, but yeah, I think all the good teams are like in the better teams are in the Europe/CIS region. So we're trying to learn from them.
I mean, you may have helped out VP as well, because they're doing very well in their regional finals as well. Sindarin, any questions for Saberlight?
Yeah, so in this series, you're the only person playing on, I guess, significant ping. When you play cross-regional play to NA, does that affect at all how you get your hero drafted? Are you, like, avoiding or specifically targeting certain heroes? And in your experience, is there a type of hero that suffers a lot more from playing on, say, I don't know what your ping is, 100, 120, than 20 like you have at home or whatever it is?
Yeah, so, I mean, right now, it's actually not only me. From what I've heard, all the guys are playing with, like, 70 ping. I'm playing with 98, so it's actually not that big of a difference.
Oh, that's really good, actually.
So they're probably playing US East, then.
Yeah, I'm still surprised. Wow, you have 100 ping to US East. That's pretty good. I thought it was going to be worse than that.
Yeah, so, but to answer the question, it's like one hero, it's Mars. It's like whenever I'm playing Mars on ping, I'm missing every second spear. It's kind of hard, but other than that, I think I just got used to it over time. You know, after playing a year on this ping, I can't really tell the difference that much. It's like, certainly, it's different playing on ping, but it's like I just adjust like in a minute or so when the game starts.
Yeah, so there are a couple of LANs in the works, and we know that you're going to Dubai with TSM. And correct me if I'm wrong, but is this the first one, not including TI, for you?
I've been to a few LANs. I've been to like the international ones where you play with like for Czech Republic and stuff. That was in China, and then I was playing with Quincy as well. So I was at the BTS Minor and ESL Germany. But this is gonna be our first LAN except for TI as Undying or like such TSM. So it's very exciting. I'm looking forward to this so much. I mean, after they cancelled Major, this is the saving grace. So thanks God, Nigma Galaxy, that they put together this tournament and that they invited us. I'm so grateful. I'm looking forward to it.
So how do you think you'll perform at the upcoming LAN?
Well, we'll see. I mean, I think it's certainly gonna be harder than any DPC. Not to, you know, flame any DPC, but it's like all the like the best teams are there, and it's. I mean, what's really exciting is that it's gonna be on the new patch, and it's gonna be like a week after the new patch. So I don't think the patch is gonna be figured out. It's gonna be like I think the EU teams are gonna do the best because EU teams are crazy with their ideas. So I'm sure like. Some of them will work and some of them won't, but at least like one EU team with some super crazy ideas like Tundra is gonna play real well, and hopefully us too, you know.
That's right, stay humble. I don't know if you actually saw if your game was going on, but at Dota 2, the Twitter account already is teasing some 7.31 stuff. Apparently Techies is getting a rework. How do you feel about that?
Woo! I know this isn't my interview.
Round of applause.
Yeah.
Round of applause for Techies rework. With the Saberlighter gray.
I don't know how they're gonna rework it. I feel like in the beginning, like Techies was super AFK hero. Right now, it's like only half AFK because you have the E with Shard. Like use it in fights, you know. So I'm hoping, I don't know, they maybe like remove mines to be like the Techies is throwing mines. So it's like, you know, it's like you actually have to play the hero instead of, I don't know, playing in jungle and watching YouTube while you play Dota.
If they made him an offlaner type hero, you think you'd add it to your roster?
For sure. I'm down to play all the weird heroes. I'm kind of sad that Moon doesn't play Techies because, you know, sometimes it's a good Techies game. I mean, sometimes it's like really good weird hero game, and I always say it, and the team always flames me for it, but you know, there's like so many good Meepo games, and I always say,
oh,
this is like a really
no,
good Meepo
no,
game.
No.
And everybody's like, global silence, and afterwards, yeah, Saber, sure.
In 7.30, there's never been such a good thing as a good Meepo game, but I'm glad that we got some of your insight. I guess now is your opportunity to show you're a good sponsored boy now. Any shout-outs to your team or your fans who have been now joined the TSM family in Dota 2?
Yeah, I want to give shout-out to all the fans, the old ones for sticking with us and, you know, supporting us as TSM, and also to all the new TSM fans. You know, we'll make you proud, hopefully.
That's what we like to see. Congratulations, Saberlight, going to a winner's finals versus Quincy Crew, and we'll look forward to how your team does in that Dubai tournament as well. Congratulations, and we'll speak to you soon.
Thank you.
Catch you later, Saberlight. And yeah, I think my camera died. Oh no, we're good again. Finger guns all around. This is NA after all. I got the right to bear arms. As we'll take a look at the bracket. Bang, bang. For North America, it's only been one day, two series, but we've already got our winter finals.